All right. Thank you so much. All right.
That's me.
Okay. Well, thank you, and we're so delighted to be back here at Smoky Hill. We really, really certainly look forward to this. This is maybe our fifth time here at the festival in the last 15 years or so, and it's always a treat for us. And we just took you to Spain, and we're going to take you to Hawaii. Actually, the Big Island in Hawaii. Hannah and I got to do a concert on the Big Island a while back, and it was an awesome time. And while we were there, we also did some hiking around. We actually did the Kilauea crater hike. You could do it back then. You can't do it now because I think it's erupting, and that would be bad. And but anyway, so we were hiking across the crater there, and there was steam coming up around us. We're walking on the hardened lava. It was very dramatic, and I was so inspired, I wrote a song. So this is a piece called Kilauea Burning. So much.
Thank you.
If you're seeing us for the first time, which I'm assuming some of you are, I can always actually tell the people who are seeing us for the first time, because I'm assuming you're looking up here wondering what this weird instrument is up here. Is that correct? Yeah, well, that's a cello. And has four strings and one neck, and it's not all that hard to play if you're thinking of taking up an instrument. I recommend that.
There you go.
But seriously, these guitars that I'm playing, these double necks, are instruments that I designed and then had custom built. I call these my 14-string double neck Git Joes. They've also become affectionately known over the years as Dos Neckies as well. And I had these built because I wanted to create my own sound on the guitar. And I thought maybe if I had more strings, maybe I could do that. So I grew up playing 5-string banjo as well as guitar. So the bottom neck, the first 5 strings are the same as a 5-string banjo. And then I had the builder add 2 additional treble or melody strings for the 7 strings. The upper neck is strung like a traditional guitar, but with an extra bass string for its 7th string. And then for further craziness, I decided to try to create a technique where I could play both necks at the same time. So the way I do that is I play mostly... To do that, what I do is I play melody notes with my right hand on the bottom strings. And then at that same time, I'm playing bass notes and chords with my left hand on the upper neck here by actually picking with my left hand or doing what's called a hammer-on. Picking with my left, picking with my right, hammering on. Does that make sense? Well, it's kind of like two guitar players in one. It's a lot cheaper for us to travel this way. When you put it all together, it sounds like... The 14-string double neck guitar. Thank you. There you go.
And I'm playing a carbon fiber cello, which means that it's completely waterproof, not that we need it anymore. So there you go. It's like bringing your umbrella, then you never need it. So that was my attempt to give us good weather this weekend.
Yes, that's
and
right.
And you can use it as a paddle. You got it.
That's right.
So after this, if it gets nice and sunny, you're going to see me rafting down the Smoky Hill in this. So very handy on all levels. So Joe and I get to give about 120 concerts a year, and we're going all over the U.S. and then we go overseas a couple times. And so we get to meet a lot of different venues. And some of our favorites are, we've played in a windmill up in the Netherlands, and then we've played up in the Arctic Circle in Norway. And we were playing in one place where apparently the town had just gotten a tunnel. And they were so excited about their new tunnel, because until then they had to take boats and go all the way around and come around this other island. And with the tunnel, they could actually drive. And so two guys in the town actually bought cars in preparation for their tunnel. And they built a small road. It was about 50 yards long. And they would just drive it back and forth on that road, waiting for the tunnel. Well, the tunnel opened, and the two guys were celebrating at the local pub. And they got into a car crash. Best laid plans. But it was a great story, and it was so fun to be there and see that. Not the crash, but the rest of it. So, and one of our most unusual venues we've played in is a salt mine, which I know you have outside of Salina, but we played in one in Germany that carved out an auditorium 2,000...
A mile below the ground. They've carved out a 500-seat auditorium. It's just gorgeous. You're surrounded by salt and... pretty spectacular, and killer acoustics as well, much like a cathedral.
So we're going to take you there. This is a song we wrote about all of our venues, because you now become part of our journey. This is what we do, and so now you're woven into the fabric of the life that we live, and that's a really cool thing. This is called Casa de la Memoria, or House of Memories.
Thank you. you so much.
Thank you. Thanks.
We're going to do the title cut to our 10th recording, and this is a song called Ancient Lovers.
I am just a simple man, nothing do I own. I've been here 10,000 years and still I need to roam. Still I need to roam. Misty woods of Spanish moss, into dusk she ran. Sun-drenched hair, her shoulders bare, a message in her hand. A message in her hand. And the night, oh, the night, dancing shadows full of light. In the dawn, oh, the dawn, ancient lovers carry on. She came to me on harvest moon, a maiden in the wheat. The night was cold, my heart was bold, and we both felt the heat. Yes, we both felt the heat. And the night, oh, the night, dancing shadows full of light. In the dawn, oh, the dawn, ancient lovers carry on. We'll ride these waves of dusty gold and cross the sacred land. Children of a lesser god are walking hand in hand. Yes, walking hand in hand. And the night, all the night, dancing shadows full of a light. In the dawn, all the dawn, lovers carry on. In the night, all the night, dancing shadows full of light. In the dawn, all the dawn, ancient lovers carry on. Ancient lovers travel on.
So very
Thank
much.
You.
So we're going to break out Dos Neckis number two here. This one I had built in 1991 in Colorado, and then in 2003 I decided one's not enough, and I needed another one. And that's because actually they're all in different tunings up here. All six necks, actually all seven necks, are including the cello. We're all in different tunings, and it's just a whole lot better if I have more guitars. I don't have to bore y'all with all my tuning. So this one is strung the same as the original one. However, it's what's known as an acoustic electric, so it's a little thin-bodied guitar. It is hollow, but thin. So this next tune is actually a Beatles song. Y'all remember the Beatles? Yeah, yeah. Well, we released our 11th CD last fall, and it's actually my solo CD. And I thought, you know, if it's going to be a guitar solo CD, you got to have a... The Beatles, While My Guitar Gently Weeps. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Little Beatles for you.
Yeah. So we're going to play you a song now that we actually wrote about our relationship, and we've nicknamed this the Storm Song because it keeps rain also very far away, and that's a good thing. But we nicknamed it that because Joe and I spend a crazy amount of time together. We've been playing music together for 17 years. We've been married now for 13 and a half of those 17 years. And we're always in the same, you know, car, airplane seats, backstage. We're just always together. And we actually thrive on that. It's great. But we wrote a song about it because it's a little bit unusual, too. And so what we started realizing is that we actually are a normal couple in that we get storms that come rolling into our relationship just like anybody else. And so when that happens and a storm rolls in, our golden rule in Acoustic Eidolon is that that storm has to roll out of our relationship by sound check, which is before the concert.
Yes, and that's for your own good, by the way.
Yes, it is. And ours, but... And so... So anyway, you're going to hear a musical rendition of one of our storms. So it starts as a love song. The gitjo, you'll hear that it sing a melody as one voice, and the cello will sing it back as the other voice, and then you'll hear the storm come rolling in. And if all is well, we're supposed to wind up back at the love song, so you can let us know how that goes. But if you want to, in the middle, you don't have to, but if you want to, you can listen for who starts the storm, but it's not important at all.
What is this called?
And this is called I Want You to Know Who I Am.
This is the beautiful love song part.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We made it. Woo.
So I may have started the little storm, but did you notice who resolved it? Me? I was a hero. I stepped up.
He got the 20 gold stars.
Oh, you have my...
Sorry, I keep stealing it.
Yeah.
So I have to sing Joe a love song after that, don't you?
You better, yeah.
And this is one that I wrote for him, but when I was writing the lyrics, I was stuck, not for lack of inspiration from Joe's part or anything like that, just a linguistic thing. And so I put the words into Spanish, and I loved how the rhythm of it just fit the song. Now, the sad part of the story is that Joe doesn't actually speak Spanish, so he has no idea all these lovely things that I'm saying about him.
Yes.
But you can find it on our website, acousticeidolon.com. It's all translated there if you're ever curious as well. But this is
That's
called...
That's what I had to do. I had to go find it.
Yeah, I posted them for him. But this is called You're the Reason That I Sing, which works in any language.
Oh.
Yeah, I see.
That's so sweet. Okay, I'm almost there. Hang on. I am ready. It sounds so much better when it's in tune.
Bringing the tide, you're the reason that this world that I know.
So I think it's time for some Led Zeppelin. All right, we had some Beatles, now we'll have a little Led Zeppelin.
Oh, yeah.
And you look like the audience that would remember this next song. So get your Bic lighters ready, or your smartphone Bic lighter app ready, actually. Those are pretty handy.
It's the PC way to do it now.
They're a little safer than the real thing. Anyway, so I'm not going to tell you the name of this tune. Hopefully you'll remember, you'll recognize it. If you don't recognize our rendition, we'll play something else for you. And one of the downsides, if you're going to have a guitar built with two necks and 14 strings, you're going to spend the better part of your life tuning. And this was in tune when I bought it, so I'm a little upset. Actually, I'm almost there. Is everybody having a good weekend so far? I mean, my goodness, look at this, blue skies.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah.
We knew you could do it, Celina.
That's right. All right, here we go, little Led Zeppelin. Thank you. All right. Well, we had a few bics out there. Thank you. Thank you so much, Amy.
Thank you.
This is the title cut to our seventh CD. This is an original flamenco-inspired piece called, River of Fire. Yeah.